As far as GT40s go, this car is significantly different than the other ones being offered at Monterey this year. There are street cars or other race cars or early cars being offered, but none of those have the significant racing history associated with them.
I would comfortably and confidently put this car in the top five among the pantheon of GT40s. It was one of the original troika of small block GT40s that were run by the Gulf Wire team very, very successfully in the mid-60s. Henry Ford II tried to buy Ferrari, and the deal went bad all at the last minute. So instead of the notion of if you can't beat them, join them, it's if you can't buy them, beat them. And that's absolutely what Ford did with the Ford GT40 program, beating Ferrari at Le Mans and many, many other sports car races all around the world, including several here in America like Sebring and Daytona. So a very, very interesting time in motorsport and a completely significant American race car. About the time this car's life as a frontline competitive race car was over, a pretty well-known guy named Steve McQueen was filming a movie called Le Mans. And it was his ultimate motorsport magnum opus. And they needed camera cars to be able to keep up with the Ferrari 512s and Porsche 917 that they planned to use in the filming of Le Mans in 1970. And it was very heavily modified for that duty. Most of the roof section was removed, the doors were cut down, and the rear section was reconfigured substantially to be able to allow this car to mount a camera and a cameraman while being driven at speed by the driver. And anything he was ever involved with, or cars he's ever owned or driven, all have a sparkle, a little aura around them that I think was part man and part machine, no doubt. It was then fully restored to its original body configuration, as you see it here. Roof was replaced, some new doors were sourced, and all the bodywork was put back right.
And then what happened to the original Gulf Mirage lightweight bodywork?
The good news is all of that rare and historic carbon fiber-based bodywork not only exists, but is included with the sale of this car in Monterey in August. And that's very important because the car's Mirage history is just as important as was its time as a wire race car or a GT40 or even a camera car.
The car is very well prepared. The engine is well tuned. The carburetors are tuned. The suspension is tuned. The transmission is in line. Everything about this car is ready to go.
Opportunities like this don't happen every day. This is about as big a piece of motorsport history from the 60s as you're likely to get. It's a centerpiece of any collection, and I'd give anything to have it. This is the car that won. I mean, these cars won big. There's really no reason, in my opinion, that GT40s, great GT40s with lots of history and provenance, shouldn't be in the same range as GTOs and Testarossa. I suspect that time will come.